Mbak Umi. Oke, hadir. Oke. So, at first, I would like to thank you for your understanding and cooperation to start our class tonight earlier. And then, have you prepared for our class? Reading module 4. Pertanyaan 2. Oke. Okay, so for tonight class, we are going to learn about our textbook, module 4, pertanian 2. Okay? Well, we continue. So, in this chapter, we are going to, we translate Indonesian text into English. It will be different. And it would be that hard because, you know, English is not our native language and we still not master in English. So we have to be careful. Please notice this point, some points that I put in the slide. Such as grammar in Indonesian language. Sometimes incomplete. Sometimes it doesn't have a subject, even predicate. So when we try to translate Indonesian text into English, we have to find first which one the subject, and then followed by the predicate. It would be a sentence in English text, right? And then, Mbak Desti baru masuk. Okay. And then, please notice about you have to prepare your knowledge of some terms in English related to the topic of the text that you concern about. How to enhance your knowledge of vocabulary's knowledge. First, you have to, you collect some terms, the new terms that you don't know, and then you read the text overall, the whole text. Try to find the meanings behind the text. So then you will know what the text talk about. Okay? And the other points is about if you find a sentence, a long sentence in Indonesian text, the one way to translate a long sentence to target language, we can cut the sentence into the short sentence. Okay, so keep in mind these some points that I have put in this slide. Okay. And then, we ever talk about independent clause for several last meeting. So, could you please explain what is independent clause? Mbak Desti? Halo? Yang bisa menjelaskan? Could you please explain what is independent clause? It according to your understanding. Yeah, right. Right. So, I will remind you that independent clause is a clause that can stand on its own. Berarti independent clause itu, kata lainnya dalam bahasa Indonesia disebut juga dengan kalimat utama atau main clause. It doesn't need It doesn't need to be joined to any other clauses, because it contains all the information necessary to be a complete sentences. Jadi, yang dimaksud dengan kalimat utama itu artinya kalimat yang sudah memberikan informasi yang dibutuhkan. Dan next, independent clause consists of subject, predicate, and a complete talk. What the subject means? Yeah, so subject that refers to the reader what the sentence is about. Predicate refers to what the subject is doing. And the last, a complete talk, is talk about something happened or was said. Okay, we continue. The other kind of clause is dependent clause. What is dependent clause? Ya, Mbak Umi? What is dependent clause? Could you explain to according to your understanding? Hello? Anybody there? Yeah. Could you explain or what is dependent clause according to your understanding? Hello? Oke, siapa yang bisa jawab? Ya, halo? Ya, what does dependent clause means according to your understanding? Are you sure? Okay. Saya perlu meluruskan ini. Ya, halo? Siapa yang suaranya kecil? Suaranya Mbak Muntri ya? Coba besarkan volumenya. Oke, Mbak Tri barusan join. Ya, halo. Oke, are you with me? Oke. Jadi tolong diperhatikan, jangan sampai terbalik. Pengertiannya dependent clause itu maksudnya sama dapat juga disebut sebagai kalimat penjelas. Artinya, a dependent clause is a clause that doesn't express a complete talk. Kalimat dependent clause ini bergantung pada independent clause. Jadi, dependent clause adalah kalimat yang tidak dapat berdiri sendiri. Because of what? Because of the presence of a verb, marker word. Please look at the slide, marker word, such as before, after, because, since, in order to, although, though, whenever, wherever, whether, while, even though, even if, and conjunction, the presence of conjunction in a sentence, like in, or, nor, but, and yet. So please notice, jangan terbalik-balik, okay? And please open your book, your textbook, Learning Activity 1. Which page is it? 4.5. Okay? Yeah, 4.5. So we can see. Please look at the first sentence. Asumsi sampai menyesatkan. Sampai kata menyesatkan. Have you found it? Hello? Nobody answer me. Yeah, 4.5. Have you found it? Yeah, tax one, model. Yes, right. Okay. Please look at the first sentence. Asumsi sampai kata menyesatkan. Ini salah satu contoh bentuk kalimat yang panjang di dalam Indonesian text. So the first step to translate, before you translate the text, you have to found which one the subject and then which one the predicate. So according to this textbook, please read for us the first sentence, only first sentence, maybe Mbak Desti, yang asumsi, first sentence, kalimat pertama Mbak. Nah, yang mana subjeknya Mbak? Sampai. Kemudian biasanya subjek itu langsung diikuti oleh predikatnya. Sampai. Ya. Nah, kita bisa lihat di slide berikut. Kata asumsi utama paradigma agribisnis merupakan subjeknya. Nah, predikatnya sangat menyesatkan. Nah, yang di tengah-tengah ini apa? Ada kalimat penjelas bahwa semua tujuan aktivitas pertanian kita adalah profit oriented. Nah, jadi yang pertama kita lakukan adalah pahami dulu konteksnya, teksnya, seluruh isi kalimatnya, yang mana subjeknya dan yang mana predikatnya, dan maka kita bisa tentukan yang mana kalimat utama dan yang mana kalimat penjelas. Oke, sampai sini ada yang mau ditanyakan? Oke, kalau gitu kita lanjut ke slide berikutnya. Nah, di dalam teks Indonesia juga ada istilahnya register. Kita bisa temukan beberapa variasi bahasa seperti dalam buku kita Text to Page 4.13 ada kata pula. Nah, ini meaningnya itu sama juga dengan kata juga. Sehingga jika kita terjemahkan ke dalam bahasa Inggris akan berarti diterjemahkan menjadi also. Demikian juga pada text 4 page point 4.14 ada kita jumpai kata ketimbang. Ya. Please you underline this word on page 4.14. Nobody answer me. Hello? Tolong ditandai kata-kata berikut yang saya tampilkan di dalam slide. Ya, seperti kata ketimbang. Itu meaningnya itu sama saja dengan daripada. Sehingga diterjemahkan kita dapat padanan katanya di dalam English word. Kata dan. Berikut juga dengan text 5 page 4.15 kata terkait. Meaningnya sama juga dengan berhubungan, berhubungan, berhubungan dengan, sehingga kita dapatlah padanan katanya dalam bahasa Inggris relate to. Dan juga task 6 page 4.16, please you underline this kind of words. Ada juga kata patut di sini. Patut. Kata lainnya dalam bahasa Indonesia itu harus. Kita terjemahkanlah menjadi should atau ought to. Tetapi sekali lagi kita lihat kalimat secara keseluruhan. Apakah kata tersebut cocok untuk dimasukkan ke dalam kalimat atau tidak? Oke? So, the main focus in translation is the meaning. We have to convey the meaning carefully. The other register in our textbooks, like in task 8, page 4.17, we found that the word puluhan juta. Puluhan juta di dalam bahasa Inggris terjemahkan menjadi tens of millions. Okay? And task 6. Okay, please open your book, task 6, page 4.32. We will found the words malah, ya. Kata malah ini, kata yang lazim dalam Indonesian text. Itu sama meaningnya. Kata lainnya sebagai gantinya. So we can find the same word, the same meaning in English word instead. Okay? And the other terms register is menampungnya dan dilempar ke. Have you found it? Hello? In task 6, page 4.32. Hello? Yeah, please underline this word. In the last sentence, in the two last sentence, kata pemerintah malah menampungnya dan dilempar ke kita dengan harga jual yang sangat murah. Sudah dapat? Okay. Ya, contohnya menampungnya dan dilempar ke. Diterjemahkan menjadi takes them in and passes the on. Takes in. Ingat, ini salah satu contoh present verb. Pass on. Present verb dalam bentuk verb plus preposition. Okay? Mohon diingat beberapa terms yang sudah saya lampirkan di sini. The other terms is about borrowing words. Contohnya dalam buku kita, task 3 page 4.13, kita dapatkan ada beberapa kata seperti industrialisasi, degradasi, kapitalisme, individualisme, efisien, homo economicus. Ya, padanan katanya dalam bahasa Inggris tidak jauh berbeda, jadi saya rasa ini gampang kita terjemahkan. Oke, berikutnya ada istilahnya, ada yang namanya linking verb. Have you heard this term before? Hello? What is linking verb? According to your understanding, anybody can answer my question? Yeah. Pantat. Yep. Yeah, maybe yes. How about the others? Maybe the others can answer, can explain more. How about Mbak Muntri or Mbak Ayu? Mbak Muntri, halo. Okay. It's okay. How about Mbak Umi? Ya, penghubung apa? Kata? Oh, sedikit lagi. Bukan kata kerja, Mbak. Ya, right. So, I will explain more. So, linking verb is a verbs are followed by either a noun or adjective. Jadi, linking verb itu diikuti oleh kata benda atau kata sifat. These verbs are called linked verbs. Common verbs like these are. Berikut beberapa kata kerja yang merupakan bagian dari linking verb, seperti kata be, become, appear, feel, look, remain, seem, and sound. Jadi seperti yang dijelaskan, diungkapkan oleh Mbak Desti, bahwa linking verb itu ada kaitannya dengan panca indera. Seperti kita lihat dalam contoh berikut, she seemed an intelligent woman. Jadi kata kerja itu diikuti oleh noun, an intelligent woman. The other example, ya, ada masalah apa? Halo? What's wrong? Okay, kita lanjutkan. Contoh berikutnya, she seemed intelligent. Intelligent. Apa bedanya an intelligent woman sama intelligent? Can you explain what is the difference between the first example with the second example? Hello? Yeah. Could you explain what is the difference? Yeah. Iya, Mbak. Action. Okay, how about the others? Thank you for the answer. How about the other? Ya, yeah, Mbak Muntri, maybe, or Mbak Ayu. Mbak Ayu, kenapa mikrofonnya dimatikan? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. So I have to make it clear about what is the difference between the first and the second. So, an intelligent woman refers to a noun. Tuh kata kelas katanya adalah noun, kata benda. Kalau yang contoh kedua, intelligent, kelas katanya bentuk adjective. So we can see that this kind of verbs is followed by noun or adjective. And then look at the other point. After appear and seem, we often use to be. Yeah. For example, she appeared to be an intelligent woman. Or he seemed to be angry. So the conclusion is, linking verb can be followed by a noun or adjective, or we can use the form of to be. Okay? So far, do you have any question? Anybody there? Do you have any question? Okay, nobody answer me. Okay, kalau gitu kita lanjutkan saja. Nah, we can found it the other example in our textbook, text 3, page 4.13. Please open your book. Nampaknya in the have you found it? Kata nampaknya? Okay, for example, nampaknya itu kata lainnya di dalam bahasa Indonesia, kelihatannya. Jadi, padanan katanya dalam bahasa Inggris diterjemahkan menjadi seem to have. Seem to have. Oke, Mbak Desti yang udah dapat nggak? Contohnya dalam text 3 yang di kalimat berapa? Paragraf terakhir. Oh, text 3. Oh, ya. Hal ini yang nampaknya tidak terlalu dikedepankan. Okay, it's okay, Mbak Napiatul. Glad to see you here. Okay. Right. Kata nampaknya, perhatikan kata nampaknya diikuti oleh kata kerja dikedepankan yang dalam bentuk pasif, sehingga diterjemahkan menjadi seem to have been, karena kata the linking verb is followed by verb itself. Jadi karena linking verb itu sudah verb, gak mungkin kan verb itu diikuti lagi dengan verb lainnya. Jadi biasanya itu verb itu diikuti oleh to infinitive. To infinitive atau noun and adjective. So we can see why the translator translate nampaknya seem to the linking verb followed by to infinitive in this case. Okay. Next. Kemudian kita ada yang namanya modulation atau disebut sudut pandang dalam bahasa Indonesia. So, modulation is consists of using a phrase that is different in the source and target languages to convey the same idea. A process to change the point of view of the message without altering meaning and without generating a sense of awkwardness in the reader of the target text. Jadi, modulasi itu merupakan salah satu teknik penerjemahan. Proses pergeseran struktur yang juga menyebabkan perubahan sudut pandang. Jadi ada perubahan sudut pandang saat kita melakukan penerjemahan. Wajib dilakukan apabila ada kita temukan kata frase atau struktur yang tidak ada padanannya dalam bahasa sasaran. Okay? Nah, kita bisa I think that's all. For example, in the source language, we found the a sentence like nobody doesn't like it. What does it mean? Nah, kalau kita terjemahkan secara harfiah, kata nobody ini dapat diterjemahkan menjadi tidak ada. Doesn't like it, tidak ada yang menyukainya. Nah, dalam bahasa Indonesia, kita dapat mengubahnya dari kata tidak ada menjadi semua. Yang penting maknanya sama. Tidak ada yang menyukainya berarti meaningnya itu sama dengan semua orang menyukainya. Oke, sampai sini ada yang mau ditanyakan tentang modulasi? Or everything is clear? Oke, we'll continue to the next slide. For example, in our textbook, text 5, page 4.15, like, perhatikan, kata bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu, in the first sentence, I think, yeah, itu 4.15. Yeah, perhatikan kata, kalimat pertama. Itulah yang terjadi dengan PT KSAR yang mampu mengecoh banyak bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu investor. What the meaning talk about? What is the meaning talk about bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu investor? Hello? Ya, artinya ya. Have you found it? Text 5 page 4.15. Oke. Okay. Perhatikan kata bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu investor. If you translate in English, how could it be? Ya, ya. Could you explain for me? How could it be? Ya, jadi dengan kata lain, kata bapak-bapak dan ibu-ibu refer to mengacu pada makna masyarakat, artinya banyak orang. Kalau di sehingga kita temukanlah padanan katanya dalam bahasa Inggris diterjemahkan menjadi the public. Karena kalau kita terjemahkan secara harfiah, maknanya nanti rancu, tidak cocok, terdengar ganja, janggal. Alright? Okay. Please open your book text 8 page 4.17. Yeah, please underline. Yeah, such as the sentence ada yang sudah menjadi bisnis. Di Indonesia farming ada yang sudah menjadi bisnis seperti usaha PT KSAR di Sukabumi yang kemudian bangkrut. Yang sudah menjadi bisnis, how could it be? If you translate one by one. Could you give me example? Ya, Mbak Ayu. Ya, How could it be if you translate one by one? Yeah. Business have become business. Nah, perlu kita perhatikan sekali lagi. Jadi yang kita translate itu meaningnya. So you have to be careful how to translate a text one by one. So we have to transfer. The focus is transfer the meaning, not the word by word. Okay? And in the text 4, page 4.31, ya. Istilah seperti berjalan di tempat ini salah satu contoh kalimat di dalam newspaper. Page point 31. Ya, istilah berjalan di tempat bisa di kata lainnya di dalam bahasa Indonesia diartikan stagnan, berjalan di tempat. So that's why it berjalan di tempat, stagnan. So it could, that's why it could be translated into stagnan in English. Okay, right, like in text 5 page 4.31, you can underline in your textbook. Please look at the sentence. Kian terprosoknya nasib petani ke jurang kemiskinan. Jurang kemiskinan. Jadi di dalam bahasa Indonesia banyak sekali beberapa gaya bahasa seperti ini, khususnya di dalam newspaper. So we have to we have to understand. We have to know what kind of text is talk about. So istilah jurang kemiskinan. It same with the meaning in English. The farmer's destiny slipped to the depth of poverty. Depth with H. Sorry, it's typo. Slipped to the depth of poverty. Meaningnya sama, bukan? Okay. The other example, like text 6 page 4.32, kata tidak laku. Tidak laku. Meaningnya dalam bahasa Indonesia itu sama dengan barang yang tidak bisa dijual. Jadi dapat diterjemahkan menjadi unable. Unable to sell. And the text 8 page 4.32, kata ujungnya. Ujungnya. It's same with the meaning pada akhirnya, pada hasilnya. So the we can translate in English with the result is. There are example like petani yang miskinlah yang harus menanggungnya. We can translate into the poor farmers bear the brunt of it. Okay. So far, do you have any question? Yeah. Is that okay? Yeah. Sure. You have to do it. Okay? We continue. So I've ever talked about conditional, so I will explain briefly. So if you have learned about conditional, what how many kind of conditional do you know? Yeah, there is three types of conditional. The first type is, could you answer? Could you explain how the form of the first type? Simple present, talk about yang mungkin terjadi. Yeah. How about the second conditional? Yeah. Tidak mungkin terjadi. The third conditional. Yeah. Past, future, perfect. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. It is talk about pada di
di masa lalu. Okay, so the other kind of conditional that maybe you rare to heard about, it is zero conditional. So zero conditional is talks about things that are always true, like if you heat water, it boils. You see, it's not always simple future, present future with simple present. So it could be present and simple present. Okay, like when the sun goes down, it gets dark. It lights up if you push that button. So the present simple is used in both clauses. And then, seperti yang Mbak Ayu ya, Mbak Desti jelaskan ya, Mbak Desti atau Mbak Muntri tadi? Ya, Mbak Ayu ya, maaf ya. First conditional talk about real and possible situations. Ya, seperti I'll go shopping on the way home if I have time. If it's a nice day tomorrow, we'll go to the beach. We see. If diikuti oleh simple present, and then the next sentence diikuti oleh bentuk future tense. Jadi future tense or moderns. Jadi future tense itu tidak selalu kata will. Kita bisa pakai kata can atau the other models. For example, in our textbook text for page what? Okay, maybe page 30. Could you help me to find the page? It's about agriculture. Ya, 4.14. Ya, you see the first sentence. Could you help me to read the first sentence? Ya, Mbak Muntri, halaman 4.14. Ya, sudah dapat? Iya, dibaca. Yang ya, source language-nya. Ya, please perhatikan kata jika. Nah, jadi ini salah satu bentuk contoh kondisional, tetapi tidak selalu menggunakan kata will. The tenses, the models will, right? And it could be the kind of the first sentence or do you see the future tense in the first sentence? No, right? So it could be the type of zero conditional. Okay, so far do you have any question? Yeah. Okay, kita lanjutkan saja kalau tidak ada. Nah, and ada yang namanya determiner the. So determiners are words which come at the beginning of the noun phrase. And also it's divided into specific or general. I will just giving you the specific determiners. It's like include the determiner the.